Hello, let's solve another problem from Hackerrank. If you're a new viewer, in this channel, I am not really giving you the solutions to the problems. You can do that in ChatGPT. There are so much online resources that you can use. Here, I am showing you how I think about it and how I build the logic from the question all the way to the solution. That brings me to a welcome to those who are new and to those who are returning. I appreciate your support. I would encourage you to stay tuned. I have heaps of content coming on. Let's see what problem we are solving today. This problem is called the captain's room. It's a bit of a difficult thing that Hackerrank has explained it in a very difficult way. I'll make it easy for you. But just as a reminder, I've got Hackerrank on the left-hand side, and I've got JupyterLab on the right-hand side, which helps me to explain the problem to you. Here's the problem. Mr. Anant is the manager at the Infinite Hotel. The hotel has infinite amount of rooms. That's interesting. I've never seen such a hotel. One fine day, a finite number of tourists come to stay at the hotel. The tourists consist of a captain. There is only one captain. An unknown group of families, so maybe 200 group of families, we don't know. The user will tell us, that's good. Consisting of K members per group. For example, the user might say, hey, there are 5 people in each group. They will not tell us how many groups, but they will tell us how many people in each group. So that's a good sign. The captain was given a separate room. So captain has got its own room. He's a captain or she's the captain, we don't know. And the rest were given one room per group. So as an example, if there are 10 groups and there are only 4 people in each group, you will have 10 rooms, one room for each group, and then the 11th room will be for the captain. The captain doesn't share rooms with anyone. Mr. Anant has an unordered list of randomly arranged room entries, something like this. For example, 1, 2, 3, 6, 5, 4, 4, 2, 5, 3, 6. It's unordered. The total number of tourists or the total number of groups of families is not known to you. We don't know how many groups. All we know is how many people in each group. That's all we know. You only know the K value, which I just ran you through. The input format, the first line consists of an integer K. So the first line, if they say 5, means that each group is consisting of 5 people. If line 1 says 7, means that each group is 7 people. That's line number 1. The second line contains the unordered elements of the room number list. So room 1, room 2, room 3, 6, 5, 4, 4, room 2 again, room 5 again, room 3 again. Our job is to find the room which is for the captain. Well, captain's room number should be repeated only once because captain doesn't share a room with anyone. Other rooms might be shared with other people, but captain's room, not sharing. That's not what captain does. If I look at these numbers, I can see that 2, I have seen 2 before, I've seen 6 before, 5, 1, 3. I don't think I have seen 8 before. Let me scroll and you will see that number 8, we have not seen anywhere in those numbers. So the answer is number 8 here. The answer is room number 8 is for the captain. How do we write this in Python? Well, that's exactly that the logic I talked about. If I find a room that it has only repeated once in the room list, that's captain's room. Let's do this. Let's make this smaller. Let's make this one bigger, because we want to solve it in Python. What I need to do is to accept line number 1, which is k, the number of people in each group. Let's do that. K equals input function the user gives me. We know that the input function, which the link is up the top right on my video on input function, input function gives you a string. It doesn't give you a number. If you don't have a number, you can't do math on it. So what we need to do on that one is to convert it to an integer. Ta-da! Let's do that. In this example, k is 5, so I will put down 5 right there. Now, next line is an unordered list of rooms. Let's accept that. I will call that room underscore list, and I will take that from the input function. Well, input function will give me this one as a one big chunk of numbers, like a big chocolate. I need to break this chocolate into smaller pieces of numbers. How do I do that? Well, if you want to break the chocolate using the space, use the split function. It looks at spaces and breaks them. So that's what it does. Now, they're going to be strings. They're coming from input function. How do I change them into integers? Well, what you can do is to use the map function and map the integer function onto them. It's like you take a brush and color them. You're taking the integer brush and you're changing every number from string to a number, as easy as that. If I run this, the outcome will not be very visible unless I convert it into a list. I encourage you to experiment, but I just didn't want to waste so much time. I directly will show you the list outcome, but I encourage you to do it without the list and then convert it to a list and have a look at that. Let me just copy that one line. And if I run this input, sorry, I need to put brackets here. How did I forget that? Run that again and paste it here. If I now print the room list, you will see that I've got a really nice list of numbers. Brilliant. Okay, now that I've done this, I need to show you something really cool. Let me get rid of this one because I don't need to print it for you. You can already see it here. There is a function from the collections module that counts the number of occurrences of unique items in a list or any other iterable. Let me show it to you, but before I can use it, I need to import it. So I'll do this from collections import counter. I have imported it, so now I can use it. But good practice is to have your import functions up the top. So I'm a good programmer, I will do that, I will keep it clean. If I run this counter on this list, ideally, it should tell me how many times number one is repeated, how many times number two is repeated. Let's see if I'm lying or it's actually going to happen. So use the counter and use it on room list. You can see that I was not really lying. One has been repeated 5 times. What size was the group size? Well, the user said 5. So we've got 5 people who will go to room number one. We've got 5 other people that will go to room number 2, number 3, number 6, number 5, number 4. I don't care about the order of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't care about that. As long as people are moving into rooms of size 5, I'm happy with that. The hotel owner is happy with that. And the captain has got his own room by himself. Happy captain. So now that I've used a counter, all I need to do is actually to identify and print number 8 and say, room number 8 is the only one with one person in it. How do I do that? Well, I can use a for loop and say, hey, how many here? 5? No, I'm not interested. This is not captain's room. How many here? 5? No, I'm not interested. And get here and says, how many here? 1? Yes, that's captain's room. All right, in order for me to be able to find a room with only one person in it, what I can do, I can save the counter as room counts, right? Because before I had the room list, now I've got the room counts. That gets saved there. And now, if you haven't seen my video on dictionaries, the link will be up the top right. But all I can do now is to say, hey, room counts, I know that you are a dictionary. Can you show me the items? It says, yep, room number 5, room number 1, 5 people. Room number 2, 5 people. Room number 8, 1 person. So what if I write a for loop, right, that goes over room number and room count? What I'm doing is exactly take this as room number and take this in room counts. And all I need to do is add in. So this becomes a for loop on a dictionary. If I print the room number, for example, you will see that room numbers are there. If I print room count and room number, you will see that room number 1 has got 5 people. Room number 2, so that's good. Now, all I need to do is to put an if statement that says, if room count equals 1, print it, that's captain's room. If not, just go to the next one. Go to the next one. See what I will do. I'll say, if room count equals 1, then print room number. Look at that. I got room number 8 as the answer. So I think I have solved this problem. Let's just copy the code across into Hackerrank and see if it accepts my solution. What I will do, I'll copy this bit and I'll paste it here, because if I don't import it, I can't use it. Do this. I'm just going to do this one by one. Copy that and copy that. Paste it here. Let me extend this window and run the code. Let's keep our fingers crossed. First sample test case was successful. let's submit the code and see if every other test case is successful, which it is. So thank you for watching. Share this with your friends if you think they can find this useful. Leave me a comment if you have any questions, and stay tuned for way more content coming your way. Thanks.